Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. Today in this video we'll be discussing about X-ray machine. We'll be covering each and every component of the X-ray machine and their significance in details. So let's get started. The X-ray machine produces X-rays, which are actually the electromagnetic radiations. Now, what are electromagnetic radiations? These are the movement of energy through the space as a combination of electric and magnetic field. This is an X-ray machine. The one shown on the right side is a portable X-ray machine. The X-ray machine has two primary components, which is the X-ray tube and the power supply. This is the X-ray tube head. The X-ray tube head contains the X-ray tube and also some components of the power supply. The components of power supply, they are important because they will heat up the filaments of the cathode to generate the electrons towards the anode. Also, they will establish a high voltage potential between the anode and the cathode to accelerate the electrons towards the anode. Then, this is the picture of an X-ray tube, and this is the diagrammatic representation of X-ray tube. The X-ray tube basically consists of negatively charged cathode and a positively charged anode within an evacuated glass envelope. All of this is covered in a glass envelope which is vacuumated. The glass envelope is vacuumated. Why? Because see, what would happen if gas molecules are present in the glass envelope, then the fast moving electrons, they would collide with the gas molecules and their speed would be reduced. Thereby the production of X-rays will be also reduced. Secondly, it also prevents, the vacuum prevents the oxidation or burnout of the filaments. Let us have a closer look at the cathode. The cathode, it is negatively charged and it consists of a filament and a focusing cup. The filament is present in the focusing cup. Let us have a closer look at the filament. This is the tungsten filament coil, which is the main source of electrons for the production of X-ray beam. This is usually 2 millimeters in diameter and 1 centimeter in length. This coil also contains 1% thorium, which increases the release of electrons from the heated wire. Now, when this filament is heated with the help of the power supply, what happens? It emits the electrons, and this electron emitted is proportional to the rate. The rate of the electrons emitted is proportional to the temperature of the filament. The filament lies in the focusing cup. The focusing cup is parabolic in shape. It is made up of molybdenum. So this is a parabolic molybdenum focusing cup. It is actually what? It is a negatively charged concave reflector, which would reflect the electrons towards the anode. Now this, what does it do? It electrostatically focuses the electrons emitted by the filament into a narrow beam. Jo bhi filaments, whatever amount of electrons are emitted by the filaments, they are focused into a narrow beam at the focal spot. This focal spot lies at the positively charged anode. The electrons move to the focal spot. Why do the electrons move first? These electrons, since they are also negatively charged, they are repelled by this negatively charged cathode. And second, they are attracted by the positively charged anode. Next, if we look at the anode is positively charged and it consists of a tungsten target which is embedded in a copper stem. So, the tungsten target, what is the purpose of this tungsten target? It converts the kinetic energy of colliding electrons into the X-ray photons. Now, see, what happens is, kinetic energy means wo energy jo movement which is there, which is present in a substance when it's moving, kinetic energy. So when the electrons are moving from cathode to anode, or when they're attracted towards the anode, they have some kinetic energy. Now this kinetic energy has to be converted into X-ray photons or the X-ray beam. So see, what happens is this conversion of kinetic energy into the X-ray photons is an inefficient process, with more than 99% of the electrons ki kinetic energy is converted into heat. So it is very, therefore it is necessary that tungsten target has to be chosen. Why tungsten has been chosen? It has some specific properties. What are they? First of all, it has high atomic number. Its atomic number is 74. Now, because of this high atomic number, it produces more amount of X-rays. Next, it has high melting point. High melting point is so, since the heat is generated at anode, to ye jaldi melt nahi hoga. Next, it has high thermal conductivity. Because of the high thermal conductivity, it readily dissipates the heat into the copper stem. Next, it has low vapor pressure. So the vapor pressure is low, so that a vacuum is maintained in the tube even at high temperature. These are the important properties of tungsten, because of which tungsten has been chosen as the focal spot here. Okay, target, as the target material, and also the material of the filament coil of cathode. Now, anode also consists of a large copper stem, which is a good thermal conductor. What does it does? Copper, it removes the heat from the tungsten target, and it reduces the risk of target melting. Okay, so what happens is, ye jo copper stem hai, from the copper stem, the heat is dissipated, or it is carried away by the insulating oil which is present in the metal housing of the X-ray tube. Okay, so this insulating oil, what does it does? It carries heat away from the copper stem. Next, if we talk about focal spot, see, what is a focal spot? This is an area on the target. The target is present on anode, and focal spot is an area on target to which the focusing cup, which is the molybdenum focusing cup of the cathode, it directs the electrons, from which the X-rays are finally produced. See, this is the target. If we consider this as the target of a copper stem, here electrons are produced in large number, means electrons are attracted here in large number. Now, as the size of the focal spot decreases, so here we have a large focal spot with large number of electrons. Now, as the size of the focal spot decreases, what happens is the sharpness of the radiographic image that would be produced, it increases. But the heat generated per unit area, the heat that would be generated in this area would also increase. Why? Because ek small area mein more number of electrons would be there. So heat would also increase. So, to take the advantage of the small focal spot, why small focal spot is necessary? For a sharper radiographic image, and to distribute the electrons over a larger area to decrease the heat. We need to have both the things. What is done? Two things could be done. First, the target is placed at an angle to the electron beam, which is a type of stationary anode. Second, a rotating anode can be used. First, let us talk about a stationary anode. So here, what is happening? The target, tungsten target, it is placed at an angle. See, this one is the tungsten target, and this is placed at an angle to the electron beam. Now, when the electrons strike at the anode, see, the electrons are striking at the anode, the X-ray photons are produced. But not all the produced photons could come out of the X-ray tube. Okay, only some amount of useful X-ray beams, they come out of the X-ray tube. and the remaining X-rays, they strike at the glass envelope and are absorbed by the surrounding, either by the insulating oil or by the metal housing. Remaining X-ray beams or X-ray photons are absorbed. So why is this called as stationary anode? Because it has no moving parts. Now see, what we can see here is the actual focal spot size. Okay, this one is the actual focal spot size. It is 3 millimeters by 1 millimeter. But since the only area of the target which is perpendicular to the electron beam, see, the area of the target which would be perpendicular to the electron beam, that only can produce useful X-rays. Okay, because the only area which is perpendicular could produce the useful X-rays. So what is done? The target here is placed at an angulation of 20 degrees. Now the effective focal spot size, see, this is the effective focal spot size. It becomes 1 millimeter by 1 millimeter. Okay, so to utilize the size of the large focal spot so that the heat is dissipated, and to have a effective smaller effective focal spot so that there is a sharper radiographic image, the tungsten target is placed at an angulation of 20 degrees. Okay, so the small effective focal spot, it results in small apparent source of X-rays. There is increase in the image sharpness, and with larger actual focal spot size, the actual focal spot size is larger. So with larger actual focal spot size, there is improvement in the heat dissipation. Next type of anode is the rotating anode. This is the diagram, or this is the picture of a rotating anode. See, rotating anode, what happens is here the tungsten target is in the form of a beveled disc that rotates when the tube is in operation. When the tube is functioning, then this tungsten target, it rotates. Jiski wajah se kya hota hai? The electrons strike at successive areas of target. Alag alag areas pe electrons strike karte hain, and this widens the focal spot by amount corresponding to the circumference of the beveled disc. Also, there is distribution of heat over an extended area. So there is a focal track, complete focal track, because yahan pe kya ho raha hai, the target, matlab anode is continuously rotating. So what happens is here a focal track is formed in the rotating anode machines. This is it about the X-ray machine. Here we have discussed cathode. It is made up of tungsten filament coil, which is the main source of electrons. Also we have discussed, it also contains a parabolic molybdenum focusing cup. This is the main source of electrons. It produces electrons which are attracted towards anode, repelled by cathode. The anode, it is made up of large copper stem, which is a good thermal conductor, and it contains a tungsten target. We have seen what are the properties of tungsten, which makes it the best suited material for the same. Also, we have seen the importance of vacuum, why the glass envelope or the X-ray tube is vacuumated. Next, we have discussed the actual focal spot size, which is 3 millimeters by 1 millimeter, and the effective focal spot size, which is 1 millimeter by 1 millimeter. This is achieved by placing the target at a 20 degree angulation. We have seen the benefits of small effective focal spot size, which increases the sharpness of the image, and the larger actual focal spot size, because of which there is improved heat dissipation. Now do not forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel. Also keep visiting. Thank you.